Hey guys, yours truly, Kevin Grace. I'm here at Hillside Memorial Cemetery in Los Angeles, paying my respects to an actor that a lot of people remember. And you definitely probably remember that great voice that he had. The man I'm talking about is Lorne Greene. He was born actually in Ottawa, Ontario, Canada in 1915. He started his career really doing radio work. And then in the 1940s, he got some roles doing those war movies during World War II. Later, he wound up getting the role of the voice of Big Brother in the film 1984. And because of that, he was offered then the role to play Ben Cartwright in Bonanza. And that ran from 1959 to 1972. He was the father of the Cartwright family, of course, starring Michael Landon. And he's buried here as well. I did a vlog on him, so check that out. This is a Jewish cemetery, and Lorne Greene was Jewish as well. Now he, after Bonanza, later he was co-hosting the Macy Day Parade with Betty White. So that was, he was a mainstay of doing that. And I remember, of course, when I was younger, he was on Battlestar Galactica, and that was about 1978. But he passed away at his home in 1987, unfortunately from complications of pneumonia after having ulcer surgery. And he's buried right here in the lawn area. As it says on here, the world's best loved father, Ben Cartwright, the great voice of Canada, finally stilled but not but silence, never the dear voice of our loving husband, father, and grandfather, will sing in our hearts forever. 1915 and 1987. And his wife died a few years, several years after he did in 2004. But he's buried right here if you come to visit. If you like this video, please subscribe down below and feel free to leave any comments about the great Lorne Greene. And of course, this is a picture of him and Betty White hosting the Macy's Day Parade, in which they would do that from 1963 to 1972.
Bonanza was one of the longest running shows of all time. It's a massively important part of classic Western TV and has millions of fans and viewers. And Lorne Greene was a key part of its success. He turned his character, Ben Cartwright, from a gun-toting, stranger-fearing, intimidating figure into a loving father. Keep watching to learn why Lorne Greene's funeral is proof of his incredible legacy. Lorne Greene was born on February 12, 1915 in Ottawa, Ontario. His parents, Dora and Daniel Greene, were Jewish immigrants, and they had a major impact on his life. Lorne remembers Ben Cartwright was originally written as an aloof man who put his rifle in the face of any strangers who entered Ponderosa Ranch. One of his early lines was, "We don't care for strangers around here, mister." He never liked the line and decided to make the character more like his own father. He was a man who invited strangers in for dinner instead of chasing them away. Lorne has several distinct childhood memories of his gentle giant of a father. He was the kind of man who avoided violence or harsh words and used disappointed silence to show his children when they'd done wrong. On Lorne's 8th birthday, he got a beautiful pocket watch. His father warned him not to wind it yet, promising to teach him how to do it the next day. Lorne didn't listen, and his father stared at him in silence before fixing the watch. He also remembers another day when he was 15. He was alone in the house with his father while his mother was in New York visiting his sister. He made it look like he was going to school, but forged a sick note instead. His father offered to have lunch with him, giving him a chance to come clean. He took him back to school and the truth came out, but once again his father was silent. Lorne knew he wanted to be an actor after watching the ones who his father invited into their home. He wanted to go to Queen's University and took the chemical engineering course, even though he chose the college for its drama program. He was unsure of what to do next and called his father. When they met up, another moment of silence helped Lorne feel confident enough to follow his dreams. His career. Lorne realized he had a talent for radio while at Queen's University. He worked at the Drama Guild and the campus station CFRC. He continued to broadcast while in the Royal Canadian Air Force during World War II. He was a flying officer and the principal newsreader on the CBC National News. His voice earned him the nickname The Voice of Canada. He was also known as The Voice of Doom because he often had to deliver disastrous news and read out the lists of soldiers killed in the war. He made an unmeasurable contribution to the world of radio by inventing a stopwatch that ran backwards. It was later known as a countdown clock, and it helped announcers know how much time they had left. He made another great contribution to the world of entertainment in 1945. That was the year he founded the Lorne Greene Academy of Radio Arts in Toronto. 90% of its 381 students found work in the industry. A few of the bigger names were James Doohan, who played Scotty on Star Trek, hee-haw writer and actor Gordy Tapp, and Lorne's own trusted advisor, Leslie Nielsen. It was successful but lost money, and he had to close it in 1952. Lorne continued to freelance for CBC after the war, but began acting soon after. He appeared in two Broadway productions in 1953, The Prescott Proposals and The Dark is Light Enough. He also appeared in other famous plays, such as a one-hour adaptation of Othello. Lorne made his Hollywood debut in The Silver Chalice in 1954. He appeared on TV several times after that, including Sailor of Fortune, an episode of You Are There, and a role as the prosecutor in Peyton Place. Lorne's career changed completely in 1959 when he was 44 and got the role of Ben Cartwright on Bonanza. The producers became interested in him when they saw him on an episode of Wagon Train called The Vivian Carter Story. They almost cast him as Ben or Adam Cartwright, but Leslie Nielsen told him to play Ben and he took his advice. He once threatened to quit the show after the first 16 episodes. He didn't like the confrontational nature of his character. He convinced them to give Ben more depth and personality, and it worked. He was proud of the new direction and happy to stick with it for as long as it lasted. Bonanza ran for 12 years and 14 seasons. It was seen by over 400 million viewers in 80 countries. It later entered syndication and has made Lorne Greene a public symbol for generations. Lorne used his popularity to promote his country spoken word albums. He had a number one single in 1964 with the spoken word ballad Ringo. The Saga of the Ponderosa, inspired by the founding of the ranch from Bonanza, reached the number 35 spot. His career after that never reached the same level of success. He played the title role in Griff from 1973 to 74. He also played Commander Adama in Battlestar Galactica from 78 to 79, and was the only actor to appear in every episode of that show. Acting was Lorne's first love, but not his only. He was also a wildlife enthusiast who hosted Lorne Greene's Last of the Wild, wrote a book called Lorne Greene's Book of Remarkable Animals, and was the chairman of the National Wildlife Foundation, or NWF. Before we tell you more, be sure to give this video a like and subscribe to Factsverse if you haven't already. His personal life. Lorne Greene earned a staggering amount of money during his run on Bonanza. He raked in $15,000 a week by 1971 and $1,000 more every week after that. It was one of the most expensive shows to make at the time, at $22,000 an episode, but its earnings made it worthwhile. Lorne used that money to make a replica of the Ponderosa Ranch. It sits on 602 South Edgewater Drive in Mesa, Arizona, and is part of the Mesa Historic Property Register. Lorne was married twice. The first was to Rita Hands from 1938 to 1960. They had their twins, Charles and Belinda Susan, in 1945. He was married to Nancy Deedle from 1961 until his death. They had a child together named Gillian. His death. Lorne Greene passed away September 11, 1987, at age 72. He had surgery to correct a bleeding ulcer but developed pneumonia. He's interred at Hillside Memorial Park Cemetery in Culver City. Lorne Greene had a private interment. It was followed by a memorial service at the Memorial Park Chapel that was 40 minutes long with no eulogies. Several members of his TV family from Bonanza made an appearance. They included his TV sons, Michael Landon and Pernell Roberts. Even the team from Alpo Dog Food showed up to honor him. Lorne had acted in several commercials for them. His family remembered them and thought it was wonderful to see them again after so much time had passed. So many friends and family wanted to attend Lorne's memorial that they couldn't all fit in the chapel. It only seated 300, and the rest had to listen on loudspeakers outside. His awards and legacy. Lorne Greene's crowded funeral is proof of his powerful, lasting legacy and the impact he had during his life and career. The many awards and honors he earned throughout his life only cement that further. He was ranked number 2 on TV Guide's list of greatest TV dads of all time. Lorne Greene is an officer of the Order of Canada for his services to the performing arts and the community. He received an honorary Doctor of Law from his alma mater, Queen's University, in 1971. He got the Earl Grey Award for Lifetime Achievement in 78. He also got the Golden Plate Award from the American Academy of Achievement in 1974. He was also one of the first 4 entertainers to be featured on a 51-cent postage stamp by the Canada Post. Lorne was given a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame on February 12, 1985, which would have been his 70th birthday.
He lay face down in the desert sand, clutching his 6-gun in his hand. Shot from behind, I thought he was dead, for under his heart was an ounce of lead. But a spark still burned, so I used my knife, and late that night, I saved the life of Ringo.
Ringo.
I nursed him till the danger passed. The days went by, he mended fast. And then from dawn till setting sun, he practiced with that deadly gun. And hour on hour, I watched in awe. No human being could match the draw of Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
One day we rode the mountain crest, and I went east and he went west. I took to law and wore a star, while he spread terror near and far. With lead and blood he gained such fame all through the west, they feared the name of Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
I knew someday I'd face the test, which one of us would be the best. And sure enough, the word came down that he was holed up in the town. I left the posse out of the street, and I went in alone to meet Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
They said my speed was next to none, but my lightning draw had just begun. When I heard a blast that stung my wrist, the gun went flying from my fist, and I was looking down the bore of the deadly 44 of Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
They say that was the only time that anyone had seen him smile. He slowly lowered his gun, and then he said to me, "We're even, friend." So at last I understood that there was still a spark of good in Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
I blocked the path of his retreat. He turned and stepped into the street. A dozen guns spit fire and lead. A moment later, he lay dead. The town began to shout and cheer. Nowhere was there shed a tear for Ringo.
Ringo.
The story spread throughout the land that I had beaten Ringo's hand. And it was just the years, they say, that made me put my guns away. But on his grave, they can't explain the tarnished star above the name of Ringo.
Ringo!